Hey, this is Zach Galligan, and you're watching comics, beer, and sci-fi. Those are three pretty good things, don't you think?
Hello, Geekdom, and welcome to the very first episode of Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi. We're so glad to have you here. We want to thank the good folks at Northwestern Tech for sponsoring our show. My name is Nick. I'll be with you the next 12 weeks.
And I'm Jill, here to make sure Nick stays in line. We're going to talk to you about everything geeky, from movies, TV, comics, sci-fi, gaming.
Don't forget beer.
Don't worry, we won't forget beer.
Don't hurt your hand.
And we're going to start the show off with our movie segment. We're going to go to Brad, who's going to talk to you about everything in the theaters.
This is Brad with Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi. They woke me up out of a sound sleep to come and tell you the poop. But we're going to talk about something I think is really good. If you saw it last week, Miss Peregrine's School for Peculiar Children. And of course, you saw the lead-in. There's some peculiar children for you. At any rate, Tim Burton's brought us a wonderful young adult novel. It's his usual Salvador Dali surrealistic style. You got plenty of good things to see. It should really float your boat, as they say.
Because our abilities don't fit in the outside world, we live in places like this, where no one can find us.
Jake, come and play!
I knew you were one of us when you were born. It's time for you to learn what you can do.
But I'm just ordinary.
No, you're not. You were born to protect us.
Promise me one thing. Look after them, Jake.
I promise.
There's a new world coming. All right, we got one movie release this week. It's not geeky, but the producers want me to do it. It's The Girl on the Train. It's with Emily Blunt, and she plays an alcoholic, psychotic, who knows what, thinks she sees something. It actually looks worth our time. Unfortunately, it's not Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi. And if you like murder mystery thrillers, we think you should probably go take a look at it.
You were seen in the area that night.
How could you be so honest?
Did you murder Megan Hipwell?
No.
How could you be so honest?
Just tell me what happened that night.
How could you be so honest?
Why are you here?
Because I'm afraid of myself.
This has been Brad with the Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi Movie Spotlight. Hopefully next time we actually have some movies to spotlight, because this non-geeky movie release weekend really pissed me off. So you know what? We'll see you next time. Hopefully we'll have something for you then.
Can't wait to check those out. Thanks, Brad. And now we're going to go to Nick, who had a chance to sit and talk with the great Neil Adams.
This is Nick with Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi, and I am sitting next to one of the true legends of comic book history, Mr. Neil Adams. Neil, thanks for talking to us.
It's a pleasure.
What do you like best about coming to these shows?
The money. People give me money, I give them stuff. I like that. It's good.
So what's it like for you seeing all these comic book characters come to life on cinema these days?
It's disgusting. I hate it. I don't understand these guys in tights and you see their junk and stuff. It's terrible with the tight clothing. And what is that?
There are women in tight clothing in these movies.
Well, I kind of like that. When you draw a comic book, one of the things that you discover very, very quickly is that you're really drawing naked guys with lines on their body and color in between. Pretty much. Isn't that what it is, you know? So I kind of like the characters to have a little bit more clothes on and to be a little bit more interesting.
You probably get asked this question a lot, but what were some of your favorite characters to draw?
I don't have favorite characters. Whatever I'm working on today. I understand that that's a boring answer, but I'm a professional. I did a cover of Superman breaking chains on his chest. It is one of the ugliest drawings I've ever done in my life. Everybody loves it. Everybody thinks it's wonderful. It is a terrible drawing. One leg is longer than the other. It's weird, you know? It's like, but you know what? People just love it. And who am I to say? Really, come right down to it. Took me 2.5 hours to do. It went away, and then it came back a legendary piece. You know what this is? This is really a fan medium. We're sort of like providing the grist for the mill. And then we just better shut up. You know what I'm just saying? Because fans wait, you know, they discuss it and they have opinions. And Frank Frazetta's Conan is better than Neil's Conan. Or, you know, it's like, okay, I'm out of this one.
When you started your artistic career, did you...
Artistic?
Yes.
I draw comic books.
Did you set out to draw comics? Were you an illustrator of some other kind when you started?
When I started out, let's pretend that it was a business then. It wasn't a business. It was about to be closed as a business. Right. One more year and we're out, kid. The goal was to become a comic book artist and then to become a comic strip artist or to become an illustrator. Those two goals have gone by the boards. We have turned comic books into the end game.
Mr. Adams, thank you so much. Pleasure. We love you and we appreciate your time.
Good.
Thanks, Nick. And now it's time for our first commercial break. And when we come back, Shannon Long is going to tell us about all things beer and Q is going to get us up to speed on the new fall TV shows.
Know that Lawrence Technological University ranks 5th among U.S. colleges for boosting graduates' earning power?
RSVP now for our Blue and White Tour on October 28th so you can meet students and faculty while exploring our 100 undergraduate, master's, and doctoral programs.
At Lawrence Tech, everything is possible, and possible is everything.
Fundraising should be fresh, flavorful, and simple. We have the perfect solution at Hungry Howie's. Doughraiser. Your team or school can sell paper pizza certificates that can be redeemed for one medium pizza at participating locations.
Hungry Howie's makes it easy. It's just a little mini pizza box, but we make lots of money, lots of dough.
Go to doughraiser.com to learn more and sign up. Your next fundraiser comes with flavored crust. Welcome to Hungry Howie's Doughraiser.
Hey, welcome to Able Ideas.
Where ideas come to life.
Come on in.
Here at Able Ideas in Detroit, we bring ideas to life. Whether it's a logo, a design, or a full-blown graphic novel, we have an experienced staff of artists, writers, models, and photographers ready to make your dream a reality. So if you're ready to see your vision brought to life, go to ableideas.com.
Jill, I want to take a moment and acknowledge our sponsors at Northwestern Tech. Northwestern Tech has successfully taught HVAC technicians since 1979, and HVAC is all they do. They offer hands-on training and have 4 national certifications.
They offer field experience instructors. They have convenient schedule options.
They're centrally located in Southfield, and they have 9 classrooms, and it's a family-owned school. You know, best of all, the program is only 10.5 months long, so students can enter the workforce in less than a year.
For more information, go to northwesterntech.edu.
Hi, I'm the Black Widow, and welcome back to Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi.
Hey, everybody, we hope you're enjoying the show. You know, we just had our first commercial break.
I know, right? I can't believe they gave us our own show.
I know, it's awesome. Anyway, we're going to be doing a beer segment on every episode. So Shannon Long, CEO of Brew Export and host of Pure Brews America, is going to tell us all about what's new in the beer world.
I'm Shannon, and this is my buddy Dave, and we are drinking on the streets of Ann Arbor.
But on a bike.
Good, there we go. High five pedal tours, here we come.
Before we hit the streets, I had to get warmed up, and Dave had to go over the rules of the road.
Thank you very much for meeting us here at Ann Arbor Distilling Company for a High Five Pedal Tours ride. The fine city of Ann Arbor has signed an ordinance to allow us to drink beer and wine only, no liquor and no glass containers. Rule number 6 is no flashing the candy. No flashing the candy means if it has to be covered up with a bathing suit, it has to be covered up here on the bike. Might get a little awkward on here if that happens. Please do not pee in public. okay? Peeing in public is not allowed anywhere, usually in the United States. Two dings of the bell means pedal, okay? One ding is stop pedaling because we're coming to a stop and going to coast down a hill. And if you hear this, that means you need to pedal your ass off because you're going way too slow. Any questions or smart-ass comments?
Before this, you were doing more of the 9-to-5 gig.
Yeah, so before I got into High Five, I worked in a marketing department for a corporate travel agency here in Ann Arbor, and that kind of set the tone for getting into the travel industry, which the way I usually do it is that High Five is a big part of that industry. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. Cheers.
Hey, for the record, this is my first ride on my own bike, so.
Whoa, yeah. Oh, I think it's well deserved. So. Hit me with what's your craft beer tour and then what's your brewery tour generally?
So the craft beer tour is Arbor Brewing Company, Ashley's. If it's a very nice night, which it's great tonight, we can go over to Bill's Beer Garden. And then the brewery tour, it's slightly different. We go to Blue Tractor, we go to Jolly Pumpkin, and then Grizzly Peak.
But you're not just here for the craft beer lover.
No, so we do bookstore tours, we do restaurant tours.
We designed a custom tour for our group that included stops at Hot Cat for beer and crack fries and the Vault of Midnight for a little comic book shopping. The final stop of the day was at the world-class Arbor Brewing Company. Ann Arbor wasn't your first choice.
No, I originally wanted to go into Detroit. However, that was tied up within the system, as I'd like to call it. So I had to figure out what else I wanted to do, and Ann Arbor was free. Really happy that I had the opportunity and have the opportunity to run a business here in Ann Arbor, just like this one, so people can see what exactly is going on here. As of right now, we are on our 98th tour, if we're gonna count this one, which I am, because it's very close to getting to 100.
Number 98.
Number 98, yes.
Business is booming, and what's your plans for the next couple years?
The ultimate plan is 3 bikes in 3 years, whether it's I have all 3 here in Ann Arbor, or I have 2 here in Ann Arbor, 1 in Ypsilanti, I'm not sure. Maybe it's 3 here and 3 in a completely different state. I don't know. I like warm weather, so we'll see where it goes from there.
Well, as all you geeks know, there's no shortage of television programming aimed at us. So to help us keep track of it all, we're going to send it over to our man Q, and he's going to break down the fall schedule for you.
This is Q from Comics Brand Sci-Fi. We're here at the big time. I'm here to talk to you about the upcoming TV shows for this fall. So sit back, relax, and let's get started. So we got Lucifer coming out, and season 1 was kind of rocky, but they brought it back for season 2. This time it's all about the devil and his mother. Ugh, mommy issues. Then we got Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. coming out. Ugh. And you know me, not really a huge Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. fan, but I think I'm gonna watch this season for one reason. Spirit of Vengeance. Can you say it with me? Spirit of Vengeance. You know, we got a new show coming out called Timeless.
I think someone who loved history would want to save it.
Our prototype. She isn't fancy, but she works. Usually.
You need to go with them.
I can't. I am black. There is literally no place in American history that'll be awesome for me.
And then we got Gotham. Jada Pinkett Smith's gonna be back. Batman, all day, every day. Can't forget about Luke Cage. Had an excellent run on Jessica Jones.
The whole neighborhood is yapping about how 2 goons got the beat down last night.
I heard it was 4 guys.
And then Ash vs. Evil Dead is coming out, season 2. Check it out. If you don't, I don't know what's wrong with you. Next week, coming back to Comics Brand Sci-Fi from the big time, we'll talk about the shows I love to watch, the CW. We'll talk about the impact that The Flash did on saving his mother, Flashpoint. We'll talk about the effects of Arrow. Hopefully no more Damian Dark and Magic, even though he really did a good job. We'll talk about Legends of Tomorrow, JSA, Justice Society of America. Then we'll talk about the debut of Supergirl on the CW and how she's gonna fit into that whole new universe. And I even might throw in some rumors and speculation in there just because I love DC so much. This has been The Q from Comics Beer and Sci-Fi.
Hey everybody, we're here at Comerica Park, home of the Detroit Tigers, and it is Star Wars night, so we're gonna go inside and talk to some of the baseball / Star Wars fans. Okay, and what brought you out tonight?
What brought me out? The Force.
We're here with the 501st Imperial Legion, Great Lakes Garrison. We're a group of Star Wars enthusiasts that portray characters that were seen in the various movies. And our goal is to portray them in a screen-accurate manner. So we do raise funds for charitable organizations. There's about 50 of us that are spread throughout this, including Darth Vader, several stormtroopers, Luke Skywalker, Chewbacca.
And what do you like better, baseball or Star Wars?
I love them both.
Does the Force tell you whether the Tigers are going to make the postseason or not?
If they don't, I got this for them.
Another great night at Comerica Park. Unfortunately, the Force was not with the Tigers tonight. The old birds took it from them, but the fans had a great time and they're all headed back to a galaxy far, far away.
Hello and welcome to Hollywood Car Minute. I'm Joe Johnson. I am joined by Mel Guthrie. And behind us, we have a loving tribute to Ecto-1 from the Ghostbusters franchise. Now, it's not entirely accurate. This is a, what is it, a
65.
65. The original Ecto-1 was a 59 Cadillac ambulance. But whenever you see this out and about, it turns heads. People just absolutely love it. A friend of mine said they saw it driving by and they almost got into a car accident because they were so distracted by it. Mel, what can you tell me about this beautiful tribute to the Ghostbusters movies?
You know, it's a very well done. It was done by some huge fans. They did it on a shoestring budget, which it's turned out incredible. Yeah, we actually took this to the drive-in to watch the new Ghostbusters movie, and it obviously was a huge hit there.
I understand that the 59 Cadillac ambulance is getting pretty hard to come by. Have you heard the same thing?
Yeah, I think it's been hard to come by for a long time.
Well, Mel, thanks so much for showing us this beautiful tribute to the Ghostbusters movies. And thank you for watching Hollywood Car Minute. I'm Joe Johnson. We'll see you next time.
Awesome car. Would love to have one of those. I'd probably do a lot better than I do with my Heap. But I digress. We're going to go to our last commercial break, and we want you to stay tuned because when we come back, Richie's going to tell us about the latest releases in home video, and Jill is going to interview some cosplayers from the Boston Comic Con.
We have more Comic Fear and Sci-Fi coming up.
Did you know that Lawrence Technological University ranks fifth among U.S. colleges for boosting graduates' earning power?
RSVP now for our Blue and White Tour on October 28th so you can meet students and faculty while exploring our 100 undergraduate, master's, and doctoral programs.
At Lawrence Tech, everything is possible, and possible is everything.
Hey, welcome to Able Ideas.
Where ideas come to life.
Come on in.
Here at Able Ideas in Detroit, we bring ideas to life. Whether it's a logo, a design, or a full-blown graphic novel, we have an experienced staff of artists, writers, models, and photographers ready to make your dream a reality. So if you're ready to see your vision brought to life, go to ableideas.com.
Hi, I'm Northwestern Tech.
And I'm a school. A lot of schools are trying to add heating and cooling programs, so I brought them all by to find the best one for him. So which one do you want?
I want a hands-on program.
All right, online schools, you're out. What else?
I want to make sure I'm certified by the EPA when I graduate.
Okay, those without certifications go. What else?
I want to go to a school where all they do is HVAC, but they can also work around my schedule.
Did you say all they do is HVAC?
Yes.
He's all yours.
Hi, I'm Northwestern Tech.
Hi, I'm Mike.
Welcome back to Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi.
Hey everyone, thanks for staying with us. We're in the home stretch. You know, with the release of Suicide Squad and the popularity of cosplay, Harley Quinn is an extremely popular character for cosplayers. And at the Boston Comic Con, Jill had a chance to interview some of these folks.
Hey, it's Jill at Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi at the Boston Comic Con 2016, here with Harley Quinn. Her name is actually Harley. Hi, Harley.
Hello.
So have you seen The Suicide Squad?
Yes, I did. It was so good. I loved it so much. At first, I was scared because the critics were saying, you know, this is a bad movie and everything, and I was like, oh, crap.
I loved it personally, despite the reviews.
And I love it. I don't care what the critics say. It's a great movie.
I actually didn't care for the movie.
Really? Why?
I didn't care for Joker and Harley's representation in it. I felt he was too mob boss, and Harley had her moments, but she wasn't Harley to me.
I liked the old Harley a little bit better. I kind of like this one. It's a little more sexier, but that's okay.
I'm a hardcore Harley fan, and I feel like she was totally over-sexualized, and it was really upsetting to see every single scene had to have the camera pan across her butt, and it was like, come on, she's so much more than that.
I think it's very different, and she, I don't know. I like the other one better.
Why?
Because in this one, she's kind of more of a sexy icon, and I liked it better when she was more of like a power icon.
I actually personally like it, but of course I prefer the Batman the Animated Series version. I didn't like the pink and the blue hair and the makeup, but other than that, I think it's spot on.
So you like the sexy Harley?
Yes, I do, yeah.
I like her. I think Harley Quinn has always been sexy no matter what. I've always been a fan of her.
It's absolutely different, and it's an amazing take.
I like it how they got to like bring her out more, you know? Like, it's not all about the Joker and like Batman and all that. They decided to put the females out there.
I like her old style too, but this is incredible. I love it.
What did you think about her voice and how they portrayed her?
I think Margot Robbie is a really, really amazing actress. And I think she, with what she was handed, she did a great job.
I think Margot Robbie did a good job like getting Harley's character with her voice and stuff, even though people may complain about her new outfit.
So let's see your best Harley Quinn impersonation.
We're bad guys is what we do.
Where's my pudding?
Hi, Mr. J. Did you miss me?
Oh, Mr. J.
All right, Mr. J.
Oh, but pudding, I don't wanna.
It's bad guys, it's what we do. I can't. Where's my pudding? Hi, Mr. J. Mr. J.
I'm not that good. I'm failing so hard.
That was awesome. You got the look though, so work it. Just work it.
I'm known to be quite vexing. I'm just forewarning you.
Oh, Mr. J.
That's a good pudding.
I love you, Mr. J.
Smile, Burn Boy. It's your big debut. Look into the camera. Smile, smile.
They're finny and funny and oh so delish. They're joyful and jolly. Joker fish.
Thank you so much. It was a pleasure. Enjoy Comic-Con.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jill. That was awesome. And if you want to know what Jill and Sarah and the rest of the lovely ladies you've seen on our show are up to, be sure to check out ableideas.com.
We thought we were indestructible. The Lords of Iron. We swore we would do anything to protect the last city. Some of us paid the ultimate price. I am all that remains.
Dear Jewel, I don't have time to explain, but things didn't go like we planned.
Really? I'm the last segment?
I'm the hook that brings people in. I should be first. You know, oh, we're on? Okay. For those of you that have stayed strong and waited for it, here I am, Richie Rollins of Comic Spirit and Sci-Fi, and I'm bringing you the home video segment of the show.
It's clobber time.
Like a phantom, this film.
Strange.
It was like a feeling that I've never experienced before. It's a piece of history.
I never would have thought that, was it 20 years later, that I'd be sitting here talking about it.
This thing just won't die.
Expect trouble.
It was long believed that Roger Corman's Fantastic Four was so bad that it would never be released. The new Doc Doom catches up with the cast and crew of the failed movie, who claimed it was quickly and cheaply made only so the movie studio could retain the rights.
We really wanted people to see this.
How many movies did Roger Corman make and never release? One.
Wait a minute. Why, we're gonna let them take this movie away from us and not get anything out of it? We gotta show people that we made a movie. That's how you get another job.
All this effort, time, and all the work that went into making that film, and then pointless, meaningless.
This film was never really intended to be a film. I said, oh yeah? You watch.
I think this documentary is I think it's about time.
Hopefully, it might be like the last piece of this whole puzzle.
The great, untold, never-seen version, the original Fantastic Four.
You can watch the unreleased Corman movie on YouTube and decide for yourself if it should have made it to the big screen.
That's okay. She seems peaceful.
My name is Erin Gilbert, doctor of particle physics.
Recent home video releases include Ghostbusters, starring Melissa McCarthy, Kristen Wiig, Kate McKinnon, Leslie Jones. This all-female reboot of the classic Ghostbusters was hilarious and entertaining, so if you listen to the critics and you miss the movie in theaters, you'll be pleasantly surprised and entertained. This movie is perfect for family movie night. Next, we have X-Men Apocalypse, the continuing story of our favorite mutants saving the world from destruction from a super mutant. It's action-packed and filled with great special effects. I loved it in theaters and can't wait to see all the deleted scenes and special features on Blu-ray. Finally, we have The Legend of Tarzan, the sleeper hit of the summer. The story picks up with Tarzan living in the city only to be lured back to the jungle by his enemies. It's an all-star cast, and this movie is filled with action adventure that would please people of all ages. And all these videos are available in 4K, Blu-ray, DVD, and streaming. And I'll catch you next time, hopefully earlier in the show. All right, I'm not going last anymore. This is it. Next time I'm first, okay?
Hey, those look pretty good. We're gonna have to check those out. Hey, we're almost done here.
I'm sorry, I'm not used to being up this late. I'll take a nap before next week's show and I'll be ready. In fact, we hope to see you all next week. We wanna thank you for watching and we hope you enjoyed the show. And we wanna thank Northwestern Tech for sponsoring us.
And if you didn't get enough of us, you can go check out our website, Comics, Beer, and Sci-Fi. Go check out our videos and our podcasts.
Live long and prosper. Hey.
Hey.